Welcome everyone to another edition of Insights, edition number two. My name's Marty Guthmiller, CEO of Orange City Area Health System, and we're gonna continue on with our canal heist theme from insight number one, and today talk about canal heist from the perspective of downsizing. As you can probably see in the background, you know, does this look like any one of your basements? You know, really, how many people need 23 ice cream buckets on their shelf? Maybe 13 would be plenty, but nonetheless, we all have that kind of throop in our basements. And so downsizing is a real challenging, intimidating kind of thing. Because of our relationship with Vision Builders, we have the opportunity to learn from real life experience of people going through this process of downsizing and transitioning to a 55 plus facility like Canal Heights. One of the hesitancies, quite honestly, that we've heard about is, what am I gonna do with all my stuff? Or as we say again in Dutch, throop. How am I gonna get rid of this? Maybe that bread machine from the 90s isn't really necessary to keep. Maybe that Easter Bunny collection that you have really needs to be done away with. Maybe your vinyl record collection has some nostalgia and has some value and you want to keep that. Well, that's fine. But people will go through these challenges, but often will experience a great sense of freedom when taking on this challenge of downsizing. Listen to a couple of people who have accepted the challenge and actually gone through this process.
We sold our house, so we had to have someplace to go. In conversation with Ben, this kept looking more and more interesting all the time, and we finally pulled the string, and we are glad we did.
Downsizing was a big factor because he was really busy with his job. You know, moving was kind of freeing because you get rid of a lot of stuff. And basically having your necessities available to you, and it just makes life simpler.
And I believe there was/is a real need in Sioux Center for something like this. You know, we have, well, my wife Glenda's sister and her husband live in Rock Valley, and they've been here, and boy, they really, really are impressed and look at the whole community, and yeah, I think there's a real need for something like this.
Six months ago, we were moving from Valparaiso, Indiana.
And we really, really liked the idea that we were ready to downsize. And it forced us to downsize quite a bit.
We got rid of a lot of stuff. It's all got a place in this house. I mean, we do have storage in the garage. We have shelving. And there's really more storage in the kitchen and in the bedrooms than what I anticipated.
And it's working out well. We've really enjoyed the feel. We found a lot of really great people that live here in Woodbridge with us.
As an example, I've met Deb two doors down from me. We didn't know each other before this at all, but we've been having lunch together, walking together. That's a new friend in a very short amount of time.
We do know that there are things that you will want to keep. That Christmas tree, two coolers instead of the seven that you currently have in your basement, those 13 ice buckets, which are essential versus the 23. We know there'll be those kinds of things that you do want to keep. That's why we've provided for ample storage space in the garage area, particularly, that is customizable with the addition of shelving, a cage. You can have a freezer in that space if you would like. And plenty of place for the Easter Bunny collection too, if you'd like to keep those in there. To find out more information, please give Ryan Warnke a call and he can walk you through the options available. I think you'll be glad you did. Thank you very much for joining us today, and we look forward to following up with you with more information to come.